One of the best things you can do to upgrade your soloing, rather than just looking at the scale position and kind of noodling and meandering around, ignore the scale and look only at the chord shapes that are happening. So for example, right above me there, that's the progression for Hotel California. I need to find out how those chords look in this position. Let's give it a shot. Next one's D minor. Next one's E7. Gonna visualize that shape. And this takes a bit of time, but there's only 5 different shapes possible, and it's really easy once you get the hang of it. Here comes the F chord, it looks like a C. Here comes the C chord, it looks like a G. D minor again. Now what you can do is just go through the arpeggio to really help you learn all the locations. Right. Hear how it sounds like the song that I'm outlining, right? And then what I can start doing is being a little bit more melodic. I just have to see the shape that's coming up. And you'll notice that even the melody even the vocal melody is targeting these notes. There's the seventh. So ultimately the trick is going to be really focus on learning how to do arpeggios of the chord progression that you're working on in the position you're in. Make sure you know the scale and then combine them so that you're able to actually see in the scale where those goal notes are for each chord. And this exercise is really good too, is playing through and going quickly on the outside notes, the hot lava. So if I want to go, for example, to a D minor chord, I'd make sure that I hit every D, F, and A, or in this case, every 2, 4, and 6, or 4, 6, 1, depending if you're thinking in letters or numbers. So I'm in A minor, right? Every 4, 6, and 1, I have to hit. So there's a 1. That really helps you to make sure that you give each one of those scale degrees its proper due at the right time in the song. All right, good luck.